Thank you. top. That's his color.
The one in the front seems like
it's... Yeah, that's a, that's more of Tuck's size, but that could be...
I think there's four.
Treaty and an agreement between them, so I'm not going to commit and say it's still what we're going to do forever, but for right now, we're the first administration. President Trump is the first president to send lethal military aid to Ukraine. I think it's very important, and I think that's something that's been lost in all the hullabaloo about the telephone call. And one other thing I'd say about this, I've been with President Trump in 24 conversations, either in person or on the phone with foreign leaders. And if the American people could be on those phone calls, they'd be extraordinarily proud of the president, how he represents America, the cordiality that he has with world leaders, but also the tough message that he has to protect U.S. interests. I mean, they'd be proud of what the president does in those meetings with foreign leaders.
Lieutenant Colonel Vindman, who has testified under oath, is serving on the National Security Council currently. Will he continue to work for you despite testifying against the president?
Well, look, one of the things that I've talked about is that we're streamlining the National Security Council. It got bloated to like 236 people from 100 in the Bush administration under President Obama. We're streamlining the National Security Council. There are people that are detailed from different departments and agencies. My understanding is Colonel Vindman is detailed from the Department of Defense. So everyone who's detailed at the NSC, people are going to start going back to their own departments, and we'll bring in new folks, but we're going to get that number down to around 100 people. That's what it was under Condoleezza Rice. She came and met with a number of my successors. We don't need to recreate the Department of Defense, the Department of State, the Department of Homeland Security over at the White House. We've got great diplomats and soldiers and folks that do that work for us in the departments.
Just to button that up, though, you were saying Lieutenant Colonel Vindman is scheduled to rotate out. You are not suggesting in any way that there will be retaliation against him.
I never retaliate against anyone, so
time is coming.
There will be a point for everybody who's detailed there. Okay. Their detail will come to an end. They'll go back to their agency. And what we want them to do is take the experience and skills they learned at the White House, take it back to their departments and agencies, and do an even better job there. And so we're grateful that we can have these detailees come in, and they'll come spend a year, you know, maybe a little bit more at the White House, and we'll go back to their agency, and they'll do a better job at their agency.
All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.